The biggest surprise was what he didn't announce as Vladimir Putin spoke at Moscow's Victory Day parade. But a Russian ambassador abroad learned firsthand what protesters think of the invasion of Ukraine.
Even as Vladimir Putin readied for his big speech, hackers were raining on his parade. TV stations across Russia suddenly displaying, "You have the blood of thousands of Ukrainians and their murdered children on your hands." In Poland, at the same time, the protests were personal. Russia's ambassador, as he tried to mark Victory Day, splattered with red paint. Protesters chanting fascist, murderer. Putin's speech was watched intently for signs he may escalate the war. "You are fighting for the motherland, for its future," he told his troops, and in a twisted logic, saying Russia's attack on Ukraine was actually defensive, to stop the West as it prepared for the invasion of the motherland, dismissed by Britain's defence minister.
I think he is believing what he wants to believe, slight sign of desperation.
While many observers thought Putin may try to declare victory or all-out war, he did neither, and a display meant to show off Russia's military might instead exposed its weaknesses. The numbers of troops and vehicles reduced thanks to Ukraine's military, and an Air Force flypast cancelled because of bad weather. But there was no sign of dissent among those watching Putin's parade. "I teach at a community college and our boys support it," says Larissa, while Ekaterina says she felt patriotism and pride and the understanding no enemy will break us.
"It is very possible that Ukraine will break the Russian army."
The display was mocked by Ukraine's official Twitter account, showing Russian military vehicles carrying looted goods. In contrast to Red Square, Vladimir Zelensky walked alone through Kyiv, saying, "Very soon there will be two victory days in Ukraine, and someone will not even have one left." In London, Brett McLeod, 9 News.